Hey everybody, welcome to this week's coloring stream. My name's Andy, and for the next couple hours or so, I'm gonna just be here coloring all the drawings I did on my Wednesday stream, Draw Something. HR Johnson, great to see you here, and I really like that new emote. Go ahead and get started here. So all the drawings this week were based on song titles. And we're starting off with Every Teardrop Is A Waterfall. So I just kind of took the literal approach. You can see this girl shedding a tear, and then you see the tear getting closer. It's a zoom in on the tear, and you see these salt crystals going over the waterfall that is the tear in a raft. wasn't noticing that hole at the bottom. Oops. There we go. No problem, HR Johnson. Just glad you're here.
Thank you.
So just as a side note, the things here writing in the raptor, salt crystals, because, salt in your tears. That's kind of what I was going for here. I don't know if I mentioned that. These are supposed to be salt crystals. HR, pretty well. Last night I streamed a game called Peasant's Quest that I remembered playing a lot as a kid, and I managed to get through it in like 40 minutes, which was way shorter than I thought it would be. Next time I'm gonna play something a little longer. But yeah, so far it's been good. Chips, like potato chips, or like poker chips. I'm curious. Thank you. Potato Chips Challenge. I've heard of that. Never played it, though. That was on Windows 95, right? I think I want to add a color splash around each one just to, you know, signify each is a different scene. Because it could kind of look like this raindrop's about to fall on these guys, but this is supposed to be a totally different scene. So I want to distinguish these panels a little bit more, so... I think that makes the individual panels a little more concrete. They don't just all blend into one, if that makes any sense. Okay, I think this looks good. I'll go ahead and stop here. And I'll bring up the close-up view. Hey, Brad Lauren Ipsum! How are you doing today? Steam, you know what? I may have to give that a shot. Alright, what do I do now? Gonna move on to the next drawing here. Save this one more time just to be safe. Close it. Okay, now this one was actually done on my first attempt at a song title stream, because this was kind of a week split into 2 weeks. My first attempt was halted by OBS crashing, so I only went for about 27 minutes or so. And in that 27 minutes, I only got one song title drawing done, and it was Giraffe in a Crazy Spiral, which is a song that me and Irene Pena Music co-wrote. And it's about a giraffe... who loses his can of soda in a spinning vortex of doom, so he jumps into it to jumps into the vortex to get his soda back. As you do. Alright, so him being a giraffe, of course, you know, make him yellowish. Yeah, now as far as video games I have been playing recently, I recently started playing the original Donkey Kong Country for Super Nintendo. And my rule for these retro gaming streams I've started doing is I'm gonna, you know, play games that I'm already well accustomed to and comfortable with. And I didn't think Donkey Kong Country would be a good one since I haven't played it in years, and yeah, given how much frustration it was giving me, I'm glad I didn't play it live. That's a tough game. Like, if you thought I was, you know, blowing through Yoshi's Island too quickly, you should have seen me playing this game, because I just kept dying. There were some levels where I died over and over and over again. I got like 3 game overs on one level just trying to beat it. Yeah, it was still compelling enough to get me to finish it, but yeah, much frustration was had. Brad, fair point. Yeah, Brad, there's definitely some games you really have to commit time to get good at. Though, as far as, really accessible games that you can just pick up and play, Mario's usually pretty good for that. Thank you. Oops. Oh, HR, Minesweeper's pretty tough from what I've experienced. A lot of trial and error. So if you're good at Minesweeper, I tip my hat to you. I don't think I can say the same. I don't go out of my way to play like the hardest games out there. It's kind of similar to like when I, how I feel about spicy food. Like, I can handle a little spiciness, but I don't go out of my way to have like the spiciest thing on the menu. I'm not a daredevil like, Great Hippo. Yeah, it's definitely a game where you gotta, you know, Minesweeper's definitely a game where you gotta think about what you're doing. No flags though, man, that's a challenge. So, a funny thing about this program that I'm using, GIMP, is I switched over to the pencil feature, and I was trying to just adjust the size a bit, and I ended up accidentally making it 10,000. Pretty sure if I just did like one pencil dot of that, it would take up the entire screen. Like, obviously the only reason you'd want a pencil size that big is if you were doing like a canvas of like, I don't know, hundreds of thousands of pixels. But at this size that I'm working with, it's there's no need for that large of a size of pencil. Fill in these little spots with a light green. Alright, that was pretty good. Brad, I'm assuming it's in pixels. HR Johnson, I forgot to do my Wordle today. Yeah, I jumped on the Wordle train couple weeks ago. Actually, more like a couple months ago. I don't know, I was curious, so I decided why not, and it's kind of become an addiction, you know, if I don't forget to play it. Oregon Trail. I've heard the horror stories about that game. I don't think I've ever actually played it. I know that a lot of people say they have nostalgia for it, playing it in grade school, but I don't think I ever played it in grade school. Or if I did, I don't remember. Hard to say. Trying to figure out what to do for the background. I don't like it just being pure white, and I'm not sure I like just having one solid color for it. I think I might do a gradient again. Let's see, how does this look? Actually, I mean, that might be fine. There's a lot of green in this one. Sorry, I'm just kind of slowly figuring this out. Sometimes I can figure out what colors I want right off the bat, other times I have to think about it. And the funny thing is, you know, sometimes I'll, you know, spend, you know, several minutes, you know, thinking, okay, this color, okay, this color, and then I'll just go back to the color I chose several minutes earlier, and it's like, okay, I could have just skipped all that extra hemming and hawing and just gone with that color in the first place. I think I might just go with this one, just the simple green background that slightly contrasts with the this right here. H.R. Johnson, you are right. And that is kind of the entire crux of this stream, so... boy. Yeah, I mean, it's a lot of green, for sure, but I think I like it. It's a crazy amount of green. I'll go ahead and call it good. There's a couple other colors in there, like the, you know, the red in the red crazy eyes, the yellow giraffe with a red and white and blue hat. So he's not only a cool giraffe, he's a cool patriotic giraffe. All right, that's the first song that Irene and I co-wrote that was turned into a drawing. Next one will be coming up later, but for right now, we got a misheard song title. This is something I hadn't done yet. For Planetary 121, he asked for Hit Me With Your Pet Shark, which is, yeah, like, Hit Me With Your Best Shot, but it's Hit Me With Your Pet Shark. So, got this little girl here using her pet shark named Pat. Nice little Easter egg there. Using Pat to, beat the crud out of this, burglar with a ski mask that's trying to steal her unicorn collection. She has a whole pile of unicorn plushies right here, and, she's gotta protect them with everything she has, and she's got her pet shark. That ought to do the trick. Thank you. Look at all I've gotten so far. Sorry, I hadn't been keeping up with the chat. Thanks, guys. Yeah, I felt especially good about this one because I just came up with it on the fly. A lot of the ones I'm coloring today, I already had figured out before I streamed, so I just kind of had to go off the prompt I'd already written for myself. This is one where the request just came in. I was like, okay, I gotta come up with something just off the cuff. So for that, I thought it turned out pretty well. Different. Make it a lighter shade of green. There we go. Now I got this whole group of unicorns I gotta figure out colors for. All right, Brad, no problem. Hey, HR Johnson, have you, it's been a little while since I've been on your stream. Have you started, using music yet? HR Johnson, you mean this country twangy one that's playing right now, or are you talking about that tropical one that just played? a couple minutes ago. Because that one's called Emerald Sea. And it's just a free song off the YouTube audio library. H.R. Johnson, is that the one you were talking about, the tropical one? The one that was like, had the steel drums, it had a very, by the beach sound to it? I wasn't sure if that's the one you were talking about or not. Two unicorns down, 1, 2, 3, 4 more to go. Alright, so we got a purple one and a blue one. Why don't we go for a orange one? Maybe kind of a reddish orange. Give it to this one who's looking pretty fierce. I think that would be a good color to suit him. Okay, HR. Welcome back, Brad. Just working on coloring some unicorn plushes. Yellow one now. Alright, give him a horn. Orange, yellow, purple, blue. I guess I could go for a green one. Or kind of an aqua one. There we go. This leaves us with one more to go. All right, orange, yellow, purple, blue, aqua. Maybe I can just do one that's like total hot pink. This one's more purple than pink. This one's just gonna be like full on pink. Like Barbie's Dreamhouse pink. Oh, and that's what happens when I leave a gap open like that. color goes all over the place. Yeah, pink, kind of like that bear emote. Alrighty, let me see. Alright, so I got all those done. Oh, forgot to color in this guy's eye. Let me fix that here really quick. There we go. Alright, so I guess at this point I just need to figure out what I'm gonna do for the background. Only problem with that one's blending in a little too much, I think. Might need to change its color a bit. I think I like this. Oh, forgot to, there's a gap here in the girl's shoe. See, I might do a little more color around this. Yeah, I like it with the color, so I'll go ahead and leave it like that. Oh, Brad, thanks for the hydrate. HR, yeah, like Brad said, I think it's a stream elements thing. And John Kulis Art, good to see you. It's been a long time. I'm doing pretty well. I've been still just drawing and coloring, though I also started doing gaming streams recently. And at some point, I will eventually do a cooking stream. I know I keep saying I'm gonna do that and then not doing it. But I am still planning on doing a cooking stream. I bought a USB extension cable so I can more easily have my camera and my computer at different parts of the kitchen, and not I can have a USB cable connecting the two. Okay, looks like this one's done. I'll go ahead and bring up the close-up view. And there we go. Okay, so that was the third out of, I think I got 10 drawings today, and I've been here for almost an hour. Oh, this might be a long stream today. But it's not like it's a big deal or anything. It's pouring down rain outside. I can look out my window and I'm seeing rain just falling. So it's not gonna be heading outside anytime soon, so I can probably afford to stream for another hour or so. So this next one is Pac-Man Fever. So we got a woman here whose husband has, of course, come down with Pac-Man fever. He's doing the Pac. He has a Pac-Man face. He's been gobbling up these dots that just randomly started appearing around the house. He's making the waka 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 sound that Pac-Man makes. You can see the four Pac-Man ghosts either peering from outside or just sneaking around the house. Looking to see if they can get the jump on him. So yeah. This was a song title I wanted to do for a while, so I'm glad I finally got it. I'm gonna go ahead and color the ghosts since I already know what colors they're gonna be. Let me see. I'll probably put Clyde here behind the wife. Thank you. I think the pupils are more dark blue and not light blue. There we go. There's Blinky under the bed. Actually, I'm gonna make his hair color a little bit different. I'll use that color, that brown color for the backboard of the bed. Thank you. HR Johnson, thanks so much for the stretch. Time for some yoga poses. I think I'm about done with this one. Yeah, I think this looks good. Go ahead and bring up the close-up view. Turned out. Alright, next up we got Polka Face. And of course I took inspiration from the, you know, one of the, probably the one of the modern masters of Polka, Weird Al Yankovic. I decided to kind of emulate his 80s look here with the afro and the glasses. And of course his face is polka dotted and he also has an accordion for a mouth. Semi-related note, Weird Al remains the one musician I've actually seen in concert. That is the only concert I've ever been to, as far as I know. Was the Puyallup Fair, or as it's now known, the Washington State Fair, back in 2008. Brad, enjoy your lurk. actually not gonna do pink. Yeah, I sure, that's certainly true. think we're about done here. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and call this good. Well, actually, hold on a second. I think I might make the piano keys on these accordion ends. Just give them like a really light yellow, so they're not just straight white. That's a little too... Maybe need to make that a little lighter. Okay. Now I think I'm done. Bring up the close up. All right, and this is actually going to be a part one of a, or this is part one of a polka twofer, you could say. Because the next drawing I have coming up is Polka Party. Alright, so I drew four accordions, each with different face styles, I guess you could say. This one has an eye on each end, and has his mouth spread across his coil. I think that's the word I was trying to figure out last Wednesday. I hear the entire face is on the coil. Here the eyes are on one instead of both of them, and the mouth is on the coil. Now we have one where the eyes are on one of each, and there's a mouth on either end. That's a little... I was kind of theorizing one's for eating, one's for breathing. And then there's some balloons and streamers to signify that it's a party, and they're all wearing party hats too. Oh, HR, no problem. I might end up raiding into you when I'm done here. But if you're heading out, have a great rest of your day. I might see you later, and hope you have a good stream. Oh, HR, thanks for the hydrate. Gotta figure out the colors for this last one. Let's see, blue, green, purple. I guess I'll do orange. Nope. Got our 4 accordions colored, now I just gotta figure out the balloons and the overall background color. My cursor got a little crazy there. Got all super jaggedy and stuff. Smooth this out a little bit. Fill in these little white spots here on the bottom, and that should do it. All Yeah, I think that works. So, and save it and bring up the close-up view. Save just to be sure. Don't lose anything. Alright, let's see what we have up next. Ah, next up we got Pump Up the Jam. So, you have these bread slices here who want to spread jam on themselves. I guess it's like a fashion ritual or something. Like, it's like putting on a mask. But they have this tiny little jar of jam that's nowhere near enough to cover all of them. But this one, Bread Slice pulls out a magic pump, and he uses it to inflate the jam jar until it's huge. And now they have enough jam to spread on themselves. So he literally pumped up the jam. This song seems really reminiscent of Vince Guaraldi, like I'm picturing a Peanuts special in my head while listening to this. So this one's either a rye or a pumpernickel, one of those two. He's a dark bread. I guess you could say this is like traditional white bread, and this one's maybe buttermilk or something, I don't know. Just trying to add some variety to the colors. I was picturing them all having just the same exact color, but what's the fun in that? Gotta have a nice variety. Wow, from the way I drew these two slices of bread behind this one slice, almost look like that could be like one really long slice, because it has the left leg right here and the right leg right here, and I didn't draw other legs for either of them, so maybe this is just one extra wide slice.
Thank you.
Okay, I think this one's good. I did mention that another collaboration between me and Irene was coming up, and here it is. Last Wednesday, she gave me the title. She gave me a title to go off of, which was "Shallow End of the Pool," and I came up with some lyrics for it. But basically, it's a song about you know, being afraid to interact and get into a romantic relationship. So you can see, here in the deep end of the pool, you got, Fish, and also Irene Fish and her husband Hippo, interacting, while this fish here is, acting shy and is staying in the shallow end, not sure if he wants to, put himself out there. So yeah, that pretty much covers it. Thank you. loop. Thank you. Hey, Brad, welcome back. How was your lurk? Brad, good to hear. Alright, I think I'm done with this one, so let me go ahead and bring up the close-up view. Alright. Getting pretty close to the end here, just got two more drawings to go. Next up, we have Walk the Dinosaur. So I did two cavemen walking their pet dinosaurs, appropriately named Was and Not Was. And the two dinosaurs are just getting to know each other. They're sniffing each other, trying to get a feel for each other, whether they like each other or not. And their tags are making some interesting noises as they're waggling back and forth. This one's going akalaka, 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 akalaka. And the other one's going boom, boom, boom. Seems like those two sound patterns could go together to make a really catchy hook for a pop song. But what do I know? Alright. Go ahead and also a key little detail I added is them they're holding the leashes onto the collars, but you know, they have to sit on top of the dinosaurs' heads because the dinosaurs are way too big to be walked the traditional way, or what we call traditional. This is how cavemen walked their pets back in the prehistoric age. Times have changed. See, what do I want to do for this one? I think I'm actually going to go ahead and save coloring the other dinosaur, for later. I'm going to figure out the background colors first so I can then determine what color would match best with the background. Thank you. Brad? Yeah, you might be right. Making one tag gold and one silver, just for no real reason, just kind of a random choice. Choose the clouds back. Let's see. Yeah, I think you're right, Brad. I think they look good white. Alright, go ahead and save this and bring up the close-up view. What up? Cheesetree43, thank you so much for the raid, and welcome raiders. Let me get a shout out for Cheesetree43 here. Go and give him a follow if you haven't already, if you're not already following him. Alright, thanks so much, Cheesetree. You guys just came just in time for my last drawing to color. Just got done with this one based on Walk the Dinosaur. They're all based on song titles this week. The theme for this batch of drawings was song titles. That last one was Walk the Dinosaur. This one is going to be Watermelon Man. Or it is Watermelon Man. It's specifically Watermelon Man and his adorable sidekick, Cute Bite, who actually has an emote of his own. But yeah, go ahead and do the watermelon emote here. But yeah, thanks so much, Cheese Tree, for the raid. What were you doing on your stream today? Oh, you know, I should actually explain what's happening in this drawing first. So yeah, Watermelon Man is a psychic. I mean, he's a superhero. So his two big abilities are he can either punch his foes, and his fists are basically watermelons, so when he punches someone, his fist literally smashes open and soaks the person's face with juice. Sweet, sticky watermelon juice, which villains are not fond of. Or he can just spew an endless stream of seeds out of his mouth. Cute Bite, meanwhile, kind of does the Puss in Boots thing where he looks, he has, you know, makes really big watery eyes and he looks super cute and adorable. But if the villain gets too close, he basically just clomps onto his head and it's kind of horrific. Very much a wolf in sheep's clothing kind of deal. Oh wow, Cheester, that's quite a commitment. Also, I love that hey emote. What kind of video is it? If you don't mind me asking. His sleeves pink or red, light red, roughly the color of watermelon. Actually, I guess if we're going the color of watermelon, it needs to be darker than that. If your watermelon is that color, you need to just throw it out because it's not good anymore. Now that looks a little more along the lines of what I should be coloring it. Hey, Goose McGoof, good to see you. Welcome to the show. 43 minutes long, wow. That's... I've you know, made some short movies of my own. None of them ever came close to 43 minutes. I think the longest I've ever done is maybe, like, 15. Also, 10 years on YouTube, congratulations. I'll need to follow or subscribe to you on YouTube. I have a YouTube account too, where I actually post all the replays of my streams. I used to actually stream live on YouTube, but I don't do that anymore. But I'm still posting the replay of my drawing and coloring, and just more recently gaming streams to YouTube. So they're all on there going back. This is week 54 of draw something / color something. And I have all the weeks going all the way back to the first week on YouTube.
second.
So I tried to do like an even mix of the outside texture and inside texture of watermelon for his costume. I feel like I mostly balanced it out well. Color in his face. Yeah, Cheese Tree, I hear that like among the only flavors of gum, varieties of gum that like really last more than a super short amount of time are, well, Extra, of course, and I've had some good luck with Orbit. But yeah, it seems like most gum brands just, they peter out of flavor almost instantly. So the funny thing is, this cute bite, this was actually a completely, this was a drawing I did several weeks ago. I think this was like back in January. For one of my friends' daughter requested a cute watermelon with a big bite taken out of it, and that's what I drew. And so, but when I had the idea to do a Watermelon Man drawing, I figured why not reincorporate that drawing but make it his sidekick. So that's what I did. I know I'm not, sorry, I'm not doing a whole lot of talking here, just focusing on getting this done. Cheese Tree, if you're still watching, if you don't mind me asking, what was the inspiration for your name? You just really like cheese? I like cheese too. Okay, I think I finally got this part done. That took a while. I knew going into this one that this was gonna be one of the longer ones to. This was gonna take a long time to color. There's a lot of little details in this one. Alright, so I got all this done over here. Let's see here. Just adding some little splashes of color around these. Uh, images of Watermelon Man in action. Just to kind of separate them from this main picture. Alright, there we go. Yes, now I can go ahead and turn my attention over to Cute Bite. Horrifically clamping onto this demon spider guy's head. Oh, hey, Elise Jang, how are you doing? I hope I haven't left you waiting for too long. I've been haven't been looking at the chat as much as I should be. How are you, Elise? Lisa, this is, I'm just coloring today. This is something I drew on Wednesday. And all the drawings for this this week were song title inspired. This is based on a song called Watermelon Man. So I drew the superhero Watermelon Man and his sidekick Cute Bite. And I'm just, I also just showed them in action. Watermelon Man using his watermelon fists to punch enemies and spray them with watermelon juice, and spitting an endless seed of seeds, endless stream of seeds at his enemies. Then you have a Cute Bite over here who can just, you know, lure his enemies to him by looking cute and adorable and sad, but then clamp onto their heads, and it's just pretty vicious. This is actually the last drawing I'm coloring today, so you came at a good time. About to do my, after I do this, I'll be doing a recap of all the drawings, and then I'll end the stream. So it's an instrumental from, I think, the 60s by Herbie Hancock. It's kind of a bossa nova style track, so, and it's, I'm pretty sure it's referring to more like a watermelon vendor, but when I see the title Watermelon Man, I can't not make it a superhero. Well, at least I'm glad you were able to make it too. Always good to see you. Alright, I think this might be done. That might have been the most time-consuming drawing I did today. Maybe. But let me go ahead and bring up the close-up view. Thank you, Elise. And I'm gonna go ahead and that was the last drawing for today, so I'm gonna go ahead and do a quick recap and then we'll be done here. So So let me go ahead and get back to the close-up view so I can show all the drawings. Alright, so yeah, I just finished this one based on Watermelon Man with his sidekick Cute Bite. Alright, so the one I started with was Coldplay's Every Teardrop Is A Waterfall. So it starts with a girl crying, and then this single tear is falling and falling, and we zoom in on it to see that there's a few salt crystals who are paddling in a raft and are going over the waterfall screaming. I made them salt crystals because, you know, people have salt in their tears. Alright, next up, we got a drawing based on a song that I co-wrote with Irene Pena Music. It's a Giraffe in a Crazy Spiral. The song is about a giraffe who loses his soda, gets sucked into a vortex, so he jumps into it. He jumps into the vortex after it so he can get his soda back. Now, this one here is a misheard song title. Instead of Hit Me With Your Best Shot, it's Hit Me With Your Pet Shark. But I threw in a little Easter egg, shark's named Pat. In fact, the shark's full name is Pat Benishark. So this girl is using her pet shark to beat up this burglar who almost stole her unicorn plush collection. But he probably won't make that mistake again. Alright, next up we got Pac-Man Fever. So this guy has come down with a bad case of Pac-Man Fever, so he's gobbling up all these white dots that just started appearing everywhere. His wife's frantic on the phone trying to explain to the doctor what's going on. And then you got the four Pac-Man ghosts all with their eyes on Pac-Man, ready to strike. And he's none the wiser. I wonder if the ghosts are gonna actually attack him, or if the wife's gonna, notice them and get her out her broomstick and start throwing it at them. I don't know. There's a lot of ways this could go, but this is just a kind of a funny little image I came up with. All right, next up we got Polka Face. So I kind of was inspired by Weird Al's 80s appearance with his afro and his glasses. But I gave him an accordion for a mouth, and of course his face has polka dots on it. And yeah, that's about all there is to say about it, but I thought it looked good. And that's actually not the only polka drawing today. I also have Polka Party. Got four different accordions with differently designed faces. All throwing a party. Alright, next up we got Pump Up the Jam. So these bread slices want to spread themselves with jam, or they want to spread jam on themselves, but they have this tiny little jar that won't cover all of them. But this one bread slice has a magic pump that he uses to pump up the jam. Pump up the jam. And it makes it super huge, so now they have all the jam they could possibly need. This one's based on another song that Irene and I collaborated on called Shallow End of the Pool. The way I wrote it was a song about being afraid to get into romantic situations. So you go to the deep end of the pool, you have both men and women communicating with each other, whereas this fish right here is he's just kind of sitting there shy at the shallow end. And I shaped the pool like a heart because I thought that was just kind of a cute way to represent romance. And lastly, we have Walk the Dinosaur. We got these two cavemen who are out walking their dinosaurs, and the two dinosaurs meet for the first time. They're sniffing each other down, and we'll see if they become friends or not. One is named Was, the other one is named Not Was. This one's tag makes a sound like Akalaka, Akalaka, Akalaka. This one's tag makes it sound like boom, boom, boom. And yeah, that pretty much covers it. So yeah, with that, I'm gonna go ahead and end the stream. Let me see who's streaming right now. I see HR Johnson is live with 11 viewers. Good for her. I'll probably go ahead and raid her. Thank you, Elise. Greatly appreciate you being here, and greatly appreciate everyone who's stuck around. Thank you all so much. I'll be back, I think, this Wednesday with another drawing stream. So have a great rest of your weekend, everyone. Take care.